If you're looking for something online, it's always worth checking the reviews before you commit. The problem is those reviews can be manipulated by people with a variety of agendas, just like the restaurant TripAdvisor says is the best in London. In reality, it's just a shed in someone's back garden. The restaurant in Dulwich was set up by writer Uber Butler, who admitted on Vice that he used to make money writing fake TripAdvisor reviews for restaurants. Sometime after moving on, he wondered whether it would be possible to create a fake restaurant, particularly now in the age of the alternative fact. So he set about tricking TripAdvisor into believing it was a proper restaurant called The Shed at Dulwich. That process involved a fake website with photos of food made with culinary treats like bleach, shaving foam, and a delicious paint dressing. Surprisingly, the restaurant was verified on TripAdvisor, and once his friends started writing fake five-star reviews, it quickly climbed up the charts. Before long, it was at the very top of the list. Butler was apparently inundated with calls from people wanting to book a table, PR agencies, wannabe staff members, celebrities, and even the local council, who wanted to relocate the restaurant to a site they were developing in Bromley. It's not clear whether these people were savvy to the joke or if they were completely genuine and couldn't see the listing for what it really was. Eventually, though, he relented and opened up the shed to guests for one night. 10 people were allowed to eat at the shed in Dulwich and were served ready meals from Iceland. There was a DJ for ambience, a picker and chicken option, edible flowers, and desserts in mugs. I assume all this is all standard for shed-based fine dining. The listing is now gone for obvious reasons, but TripAdvisor has said that the situation behind the shed isn't anything people should worry about. Generally, the only people who create fake restaurant listings are journalists in misguided attempts to test us, replies a representative via email. As there is no incentive for anyone in the real world to create a fake restaurant, it is not a problem we experience with our regular community, therefore this test is not a real world example. Adding, most fraudsters are only interested in trying to manipulate the rankings of real businesses, so the distinction between attempted fraud by a real business, as opposed to attempted fraud for a non-existent business, is important. Crazy, right? I suppose it just goes to show that anything is possible on the internet. Nothing is true, and nothing is forbidden. Vice via standard more WTF posts.